皆さんこんにちは。神戸大学の芥川です。OSB 研究会の代表理事をしています。で今日はですね、2020年3月、5日、で、3月4日、ですけれども、最近コロナウイルスの影響によってさまざまなイベントが中止されていまして、我々も3月2日に予定していた東京セミナーがキャンセルになったんですけれども、その時に講演を予定していただいていたフレディ・ドラン先生に来ていただいております。で、この部屋は神戸大学工学部の中にあります先端膜工学研究拠点の3階の部屋なんですけれども、OSB の研究をしている我々の学生の部屋、それからこういう OSB の関連製品とかポスターを置いている部屋です。それでは、これから、フレディ・デュラン先生に、ペルーのいろんな事情なんかを含んだお話をしていただきたいと思います。じゃあフレディ先生、よろしくお願いします。
どうもありがとうございます。皆さん、こんにちは。私はフレディ・デュランです。ペルーのリマから来ました。神戸大学で25年前ぐらいに卒業したんですけども、今回私コンサルタントとプロフェッサーでペルーで、仕事もやってます。この日本で、京都大学の10年前ぐらいに、10年間ぐらい准教諭まで仕事をしました。私の専門、もともと地震工学、それとライフライン工学、今トンネル工学ですけども、皆さん今これですけども、今私のプレゼンテーション英語でやります。どうもありがとうございます。はい、始まります。You can see here、the title of my presentation、no? This is theYou can read is the assessment of rockfall due to erosion of cliffs along the coastal lines and the need for real-time monitoring. I will present a very serious case that is in the Costa Verde cliffs in Lima City, Peru. You can see here the current view of the problem, no?Is about 20 kilometers length, no, the, of cliffs of several heights, no, in the terminal point and in the initial point, maybe 20 meters height, and it reached maybe 80 meters or more at the mid part. You can see here. Okay, the problem here is, as you can see, the city is, the buildings are very close, no, to the border, to the top border of the cliffs. And besides this, you can see that the sea border is really near. So now the main problem that to study here is how to monitor this, soil behavior, how to monitor the erosion problems, how to study the stability, how to make safety, no, this, all of this coastal area. As you can see here, the slopes are very steep, no? You can see maybe from 70 degrees and 90 degrees. Look at the problems, no? The problems here, for example, the buildings are, in several cases, just at the border of the cliffs. About this also, we have another problem, not only at the borders, but in other places, the buildings, the massive construction is very near the border. No? This is another problem. Another problem is the humidity, because this is near the, or it's just close to the sea. And the material, the soil material of these cliffs is another problem. Of course, there are several cases that must be studied, no, to understand this problem. Unfortunately, we don't have any monitoring work till now. Even if the authorities created a commission to monitor, to study this almost 15 years ago, no? And I will show later the advances of the studies, no? In order to study this problem. You can see here, for example, this is the terminal part, no? In the terminal part, there is no road, no? It's just the sea and the cliffs, no? And you can see here the loose soil material, and several layers composed of this loose material, loose soil material, okay? And you can see also here that is the layers, no? And the effect of the wind and the erosion, humidity on these cliffs. So it makes a big problem. Another problem is at the terminal part, for example, this is we can see garbage, no? And some parts of the cliffs collapsed, failed, because not only because the stability, but also because some sewage connections, sewage pipes. So we are talking about a serious problem on almost, I say, 20 kilometers. It's not so small, the problem. Then we can summarize this in this case, for example, saying that the high risk of cliff failures may occur due to earthquakes and also tsunami. What would may happen if tsunami may occur? No, it will impact on the cliffs, and we don't know the phenomena that will occur. So this is a big problem. The studies, just the Geophysical Institute of Peru detected 77 cliff faults, but these studies are based just on observations, maybe, but not on real monitoring system. So just take it as reference, please. The other situation, the situation become worse because, as you can see here, new highways are constructed, no, over crossings and very close to this. And the other problem with this stability of the cliffs is that along the highways you cannot see any retaining wall, no, here are 100% exposed. So it's a high risk area. So is the monitoring really is needed, not only in the cliffs but also at the border, no, in order to see what is happening, no? with the stability of the soil. And for example, this is the actual, for example, construction. I will pass. This is actually, no, this a 3 kilometer highway that they are constructed in at the terminal part of these cliffs, no? And as you can see, no retaining wall, just roads. But this is the world. Now you can see one retaining wall here, but it's a very, very, how can I say, the height no more than 3 meters, or maybe 3 meters five at most, no more. And you can see this is the state. So we can summarize the risk of collapse, no, by mentioning the following problems: erosion and humidity in the cliffs, no, increase of building loading, existence of cracks along the cliff, at the cliffs, and the irrigation of the gardens, and all of the city contribute also to this instability problems. So we need a really monitoring to assess these problems. No, that unfortunately we don't have. No, just this is just to mention that in 1995, no, almost 25 years ago, no, one authority was created just on purpose for the protecting or for dealing with the protection of the cliffs. No, several rock slides occur. No, occur one fire in 2016, one earthquake in 2018, and in last year, 500 meters out of 2 kilometers with small rock slides occurred there. No, so now they study the problem and they regulate the construction. That's saying that any building from now should be constructed 120 meters, no, far from the borders of the cliff. But this is just without any, how can I say, study, with verification study or serious study. It's just, we can say, a practical decision. Most of the problems that have mentioned here are of this, no? The rocks impact on the vehicles and occur accidents, even deaths. This is just to see in figures, no, what is the effect of these rock slides, no, and usually the cars are the most affected. The protection, this is the actual protection of the cliffs, no. You can see geogrids and metallic grids, but these geogrids are very flexible. No, have not any resistance, and you can, as you can see here, is just like a curtains. That's all, no more. And at the base, it's constructed some how can I say, poles with metallic grids, no, to protect. But this is almost nothing related to safety, no, just to control in some way the smallest rock slides. The other problem, why we need a real monitoring, is this also. 30 years ago, these laws didn't exist. Now, these laws, as you can see, buildings are increasing. If we just, as we make a simple calculation, there are maybe millions of tons, no, that is increasing, constantly increasing along the cliffs, no, and it really affects us. What would happen during an earthquake? This is the problem. We don't know, for example, what is the permanent deformation at this point in this figure, also here, and control it. But this is the real situation. And even just 2 years ago, big foundations at top of the cliffs. No, this is another problem. More pictures just to illustrate. I will not go in detail, but just for illustration purposes. And look at here, several type of foundations, maybe not suitable foundations. No, this is another point that we lack. No. Maybe we need some special studies, special recommendations that which kind of foundation should be in these particular conditions. We don't have. This is just a matter of building foundation, and that's all. This is a big problem. There are many parts that the construction even is just very simple, no, without technical assistance. So as you can see here, it's very empirical, no? In one part is very, very nice, very good, but the many parts are like this. And look at the protection, that's all. This is another case, no? I don't want to go in detail, but definitely in case of big earthquake, this is, frankly, maybe this will collapse. Now, I will mention two cases, no, that of a study, no. One, the two cases of the many that occur. One is the loose soil slides due to erosion and some rock slides, no? Two problems. This problem occurred, as you can see here, last year, no? Just to mention the newest problem, no? In August of last year, at midnight. And the extension is about 25 to 30 meters wide, no? And you can see the way it collapsed, it failed. We can make some conclusions about this phenomena or this problem. The geogrids and protection system have been destroyed, so almost didn't help so much, no? As you can see, no? So this is not a solution. We need to think another solution. The other problem is, for example, the soil, no? It's loose soil, non-consolidated soil that and many, how can I say, combination of a granular soil and silty clay soil. And result is what you are looking here. Okay, just this is pictures just to illustrate, but please see that all of this is protected with geogrids, no? But really the protection is almost nothing. Here, this is another picture just to show the extension of the fail. And the purpose of this figure is just to see a close up of the material, no? The soil material that is a composite, no? You can see here. Okay, this is a view that of the problem, no? In this a panoramic view. As this problem, we will have a lot of this problem in the future, in the near future, and more frequently, maybe. And the question is, what this slide, what is a rock slide? What is the case? What is the factors, no, that induced to this landslide or rock slide? Maybe the erosion, this is one. The humidity, this is one. The load, the loading of the building, this is another, no? And the temperature, maybe the effects, also another problem. And also the soil material variation along the height of the cliffs. But what I am saying is maybe, but we don't have exact data about, for example, this problem. How to study this problem, I will show later. But just assuming data from soil laboratory tests, that is just it's quite different from the real condition, no? Absolutely different. This is what we need here, no? Just there are some views, no? Can see just to illustrate, and this is the case two, no? The case two is very similar. This occurred just on December of this, almost 2 or 3 months after the problem that I mentioned. And another part, look at the other, in this case, there are no tall buildings, no? But they are very small. However, it occurred, no? The problem. So in this case, for example, is very, very similar. It's quite similar. Here, I want to point. This is the problem, no? The material and the protection. Actually, to study these problems, we rely just on FEM analysis. No, any problem that occur and that is going to evaluate it, the finite element analysis is used. But we know very well that a final element analysis, you know, the border between elements, the boundary conditions is perfect, no? But maybe some we need experts to recommend, is it possible to make final element analysis with this kind of soil material? No? Maybe if the cliffs would be very stiff, the material would be in another condition, maybe. But in this case, doing the final element analysis, I don't know what is the reliability, no? Maybe we can have results, but we don't know, no? How, if are suitable or not. Surely, in my opinion, are not suitable, such results. And we can see here more views about this problem. And look at the deep, no? The steep of the cliffs. Okay. In the problem here is not only that in 20 kilometers the soil material is uniform. The problem is that it's not uniform. And in several places we have a garbage, like a fill material, and this is another condition that we should evaluate, no? For example, truly speaking, we don't know exactly the constitution of the layers of this. I will show it in the second part of this presentation, one study, but assuming these conditions, one serious study assuming these conditions, okay? So, what is the response of the authorities to this problem? What I am telling now is the decision taken last year, August, on August 12th. They said, let's integrate the evaluation, no? Let's do an integral evaluation of buildings. Let's delimitate the risk zones. Let's perform stabilization works at the collapsed zone of the cliff. And let's prepare some guidelines for slope stabilization based on public investment. These are the countermeasures at March 4th of this year. No, actually, you can see that there is not monitoring, no, studies, even expectations. No? So, is it possible to solve the problem with this confirmation, with this response? No. So, this is the purpose of this presentation. No? We have good intentions to solve the problem, but with empirical, we are already empirical. No? So we need really the monitoring system for all of these problems. This is what they are doing actually in this, you know, performing stabilization works at the top of the collapsed zone, for example. Mm-hmm. You can see some bulldozers, maybe, but this is just a pill for one illness person, no? Just treating the zone, no? The collapsed zone, but no more. No installation of monitoring devices, no construction of, protection walls or any based on studies, no. This is the okay, so finally, to make this presentation end, they decided to place a concrete post, no, galvanized with galvanized wire, and supporting the meshes along 15 kilometers. Okay, so this is the results of the study until now. Thank you very much for this part of the presentation.